It's a tough thing. What is my favorite part of playing Wolverine? He is, to me, the most badass comic book character out there. Way cooler than me, way tougher than me. So I kind of get to have great wish fulfillment playing him. In fact, I should tell you, my son, who's about to turn 13, just recently said to me, he goes, "I used to think you were really like Wolverine, but you're actually not that." So it's kind of really fun playing the toughest guy in the yard. How much training goes into Wolverine? The simple answer is a lot. I basically work out for 3 hours a day, 2 hours in the morning, and then wherever I can during the day, I fit in another hour. But I'll be honest with you, the most important thing about the training is the eating. In fact, 70% of how you look is how you eat. Only 30% is the training. So that's probably the more vital thing. Great question. Japan factors in a massive way. I don't know if you're a fan of the comic book saga, the samurai saga, but I know a lot of fans are. I was a big fan of it. The movie is set in Japan. We shot in Japan. It really feels different. The look of it is different. The atmosphere is very different from any other X-Men movie. And through Wolverine, you enter this world. He's very much a fish out of water. And I think the audience will feel that too. It's a very enigmatic, mysterious, and fascinating world. I think what I love about this Wolverine movie and why it's called The Wolverine and not Wolverine 2 is it's a completely different, not only tone, but I think you get the definitive look at the character. And for many of the movies, we concentrate on his lack of memory. And he's in this movie, we really concentrate on his immortality and the implications of that and what the future means for someone like Wolverine. I think the fans will really find it refreshing and different and very cool. Would I like to live as long as Wolverine? Yeah, absolutely. I don't know many people who wouldn't. Mind you, if I was Wolverine, I'd probably have second thoughts. He's someone with a lot of regret and pain, and life is not easy for him. And actually, one of the great things about this movie is you see the implications of almost being immortal. And is it a good thing to live a long life if you're living with a lot of pain and regret? Or is it a burden? That's really where we find Wolverine at the beginning of the movie. And I don't want to give away much more than that. I think the thing I loved about this Wolverine, it was really brand new cast. Obviously, the movie takes place in Japan, and we have some incredible Japanese actors. I'd never forget, we were shooting a scene, and we had 200 extras, and at the end of the day, Hiro, who's in the movie, has done about 80 Japanese movies. People were not impressed to see me. They were literally falling over themselves to see Hiro, the fact they're in a movie with him. We have some of the greatest Japanese actors. We also have brand new actors, and I think for audiences it's going to be exciting. There are new mutants. I don't want to give too much away, but in every way this movie is going to feel fresh. For me as an actor, it felt completely fresh and exciting. For me, the thing I'm most excited about for you guys to see is some of the action. We really decided on this movie because we had this incredible new canvas of Japan. We had samurais, we had a whole new palette to work with that we could give and make action that was fresh and exciting that hadn't been seen before. And I'm just going to say two words: bullet train. Is it tough to turn off Wolverine? I use it occasionally. you know, you want to get reservations, restaurants, you want to get a seat on the subway. There's places where it comes in handy. But actually, mate, it's been 12 years I've been playing him, and I can turn it on and I can turn it off pretty quickly, thankfully. I don't know if I'd be very welcome at home if I was just scowling and calling everyone bub. The movie is called The Wolverine, and is there pressure? I suppose there is pressure. I feel pressure on every movie, but the right kind of pressure. I suppose in a sports analogy, at the end of the game, do people want the ball to shoot the hoop? Yeah, they do. And so in that way, it's good, but it is always a team effort. And in this movie, there are so many other great characters and great actors, and Jim Mangold, who's a fantastic director, just made that pressure feel completely manageable. And the movie's called The Wolverine, and what I love about it, I think more than ever before, you get a definitive look at this character and what makes him who he is. And I've been playing him for 12 years now, so I was really looking forward to the Japanese saga. James Mangold is a great friend of mine. We did a movie together called Kate and Leopold, which probably couldn't be more opposite from this. But he is an incredible director. He has great vision. He has big ambition. And he's done a lot of great movies. So when someone like James Mangold signs on to the Wolverine, you know you're not just going to get, oh, it's another Wolverine. You know you're going to get something definitive. You know you're going to get something fresh. And you're gonna get something that's really worth your time. For me, I loved it every day. It was the most fun I've had, and I hope you enjoy the result as much as I enjoyed making it. Looking for some scoops on Days of Future Past. All right. The mutton chops are still there. I don't think I'm giving you any real scoops if I tell you that pretty much all the old X-Men are back. And when I say the old X-Men, I mean from the X-Men movies and from X-Men First Class. It is probably one of the most exciting ensembles ever kind of put together, really, for a film. I mean, the list on any day's call sheet is pretty impressive. But I think the really exciting thing beyond that is the new characters that are coming and the actors that are doing that. So Simon P told him nothing except how much fun it is and how mind-blowing it is to be working with all those actors and to be back with Brian again. 12 years since we all began. Yeah, our conversations are very different from what bar should we go to how are the kids doing. So it's all very different.